Good morning from Hamburg. My name is Enrico Dressler. I'm System Design Engineer at Trinamic, and today I want to show how to use the Encoder Wizard with one of our Brushless CC modules. For this how-to, I use a TMCC160A evaluation board and a motor with digital Hall sensors and an incremental encoder. For the communication with the laptop, I choose a USB to CAN adapter. After connecting the CAN adapter with the laptop, the board has been found on the CAN bus. Now we can select Tools and Wizard, and we get an overview about the available wizard for this module. Now I select encoder wiring. On the first page of the wizard, there's a short introduction for the wizard and an image of the module. Here you can see the connector for the motor and the encoder signals. The wizard uses the open loop mode to rotate the motor slowly with a constant torque. We can select this torque here and start the motor. Afterwards, we take a look to the actual commutation angle used for the open loop mode. This is the blue line, and we compare it with the commutation angle computed by the actual encoder signals. This is the red line. If both signals are crossed, we have to update the encoder direction. But if both signals are running in parallel, all the settings are correct and we can go to the next step. In the next step, I use the open loop mode to check the motor pole count and the encoder resolution. Therefore, I start the motor with a slow velocity and read out the motor pole count after exactly one rotation. For a better accuracy of the estimated encoder resolution, it is better to rotate the motor several revolutions. In the last step, we can use the new encoder settings and control the motor with different velocities. Therefore, I choose the encoder mode and start the motor with 1000 RPM in different directions. My name is Enrico Dressler, and today I showed you how to use the encoder wizard with one of our Brushless DC modules. Thanks for watching and goodbye!